Who's excited? Who's expecting? At this moment, I will invite the Vice Director, Sir Laurence Chileshe.
Yes, come on now. Get your jams on. your seats.
Amen. Is everybody going to get me? At the back? So I was given an assignment by God, by my director. I was told when you're coming, I have one assignment for today. So I'm still a bit cut from. I was from an all night, so I'm musical tonight. Amen. Who's attending World Empowerment Movement for the very first time?
Corrected. Look at your neighbor
Now if you know me very well, I don't say things to excite me. I say things that God has told me to say. There is a natural order of things. In a kingdom, a servant cannot be on our boats. Mercedes-Benz S500. Can you imagine? Let me bring it to today's scenario. Can you imagine you are living in your house and the person that helps, the person that comes to clean your house, is parking their Range Rover while you are going to get on a bus when you are going to work? There is an error somewhere. Now that is what has been going on in quite a lot of people's lives. And God today has said that the error must be corrected. So what then is an error? An error is anyone that is not right. An error is a mistake, incorrect or false knowledge, inaccuracy, deviating from the original. What was the original plan that God had for you? There's a reason that it has been called the renewed mind. There are many people who still think that poverty is humility. There are believers who think that you must first work 20 years for you to build your house. There are believers who think that the way for the church is to struggle. If you know, this is just how we are. No, you know, my grandfather was like this. Even my father is like this. Even me, it's obviously going to be like this. The mind must be renewed. So what is the renewed mind? The renewed mind is the mind of Christ. Simply. When you have the mind of Christ, you think from heaven towards earth. Can I give you an example? Yes, Jesus is in a meeting and he tells the disciples, can you imagine a meeting like this? And Jesus is a good man and he says, let's find food. How many like food? We're not eating food today. And then this little boy comes and he says, find food. And this is, first of all, the disciples were not poor. Do you know that? Amen. In every church, they were hungry with that church. Is it 4,000? And they say, even if we were to go into the town to buy food, they did not say first to start fundraising for the food. Amen. Meaning the money was there. Amen. So people who tell you that Jesus was poor are living in an era. Jesus' ministry was so vast that he had a treasure.
Yes, sir.
Judas was a treasure. Do you know that? What a treasure is. Jesus' clothes were so awesome that when he died on the cross, people got the clothes and began to gamble as to who would get the clothes. People don't gamble over things that are not worth any.
Yes.
The clothes that he was wearing when he was in a budget meeting were such that people would get them and he would sell and have money. So as I say, the mind has things from heaven towards earth. A lot of us are thinking from earth to heaven, which is why we are always bleeding to heaven. When you have a mindset that things from heaven towards earth, you get to understand that what God has for you has already been made available. Which is why you pray as it is in heaven on the earth.
Amen.
Someone did hear that. So Jesus, and what does he do? He gives thanks. When I give you something, what do you do? He already knew what was available. People were seeing two loaves and three fish. He was seeing enough food to feed 4,000 and have baskets remain. That is the mindset that is in Christ, and that's the mindset that you're supposed to have. I'm just going to challenge someone and renew your mind. Read the word. What does the word say about you? And that is true. It is not a story. Long ago we would preach miracles, miracles, miracles. But because our minds were such that for you to perform a miracle, you must first go in the closet and then fast, kiss the days, and then come and lay hands on the headache and it goes. So you can imagine the amount of food you do for a dead person. Look at your neighbor and tell them, I have a mind of heaven. I'm already way behind that. So I'm just here to set a few things in motion. Amen. So you cannot have a renewed mind until you are in line with the word. When the word of God becomes a reality, it is easy and set for you to do anything. Do you know that it is possible for a believer to live without sin? Do you know why many of us struggle with that? Because we have not accepted that part of the world. You can live as a believer without sin. When we come and intercession is being led, confess your sins, you start. Maybe even begin to repent of pride. Oh God, forgive me of this pride. I think I have not sinned.
Come on, sir.
This error must be corrected. So the error is that servants are on horses while princes are walking. Now what is the cause for this error? Firstly, number one, it could be because that the prince doesn't know that he is a prince. Now who is a prince? A prince is a son of a king. Okay? Now firstly, we are not just princes. Do you know that the Bible calls us kings? Can you imagine His Excellency, President Edgar Chakwalungu, walking in the streets as you are driving past him in your nice car? You can't even begin to conceive it. Because you know that when he is coming, things must begin to move out of the way. In the same way, that must be your life. When you are progressing, things must begin to move out of your way. It was interesting because a friend of mine was failing to congratulate me. Nice, Pastor Kali. You took the fun out of congratulating you a long time ago. Delay is not of God. It is not in His will for you. It is not in His plan for you. Check the word. Amen. You need to do a few prophetic acts.
Yes, sir.
So, just at your feet. With your notes, with your notes. I'm a person that keeps time, like certain people in the ministry. So I will give you just a few things that sponsor and allow this error to go on in the lives of believers. Have we established that believers are not supposed to be on the ground while servants are walking? While servants are walking. As a believer, your life must be progress. Now, let's deal with another thing quickly. Progress is also in levels. Do you know that? Do you know that the person walking and the person driving are progressive? Do you know that the person driving and the person flying are progressive? How many hours drive is it from here to Joburg? It's 2 days. How many hours walking is it from here to Joburg? How many hours flying is it from here to Tokyo?
Just because
you awesome God. Just come.